Hi, I'm Michelle. I'm the Children's Librarian at the Sheridan County Public Library System, and welcome to another episode of Bookmarks. Now, I'm sure you've heard about Peter Pan, Wendy, Never Never Land, The Lost Boys, but have you read the book, Peter Pan, by J.M Barrie? Because this is wonderful. And it starts out like this. This is a really neat edition. This is illustrated by Trina Sharp Hyman. And she has all sorts of wonderful details in her pictures. And it starts out like this. All children, except one, grow up. They soon know that they will grow up, and the way Wendy knew was this. One day when she was 2 years old, she was playing in the garden, and she plucked another flower and ran with it to her mother. I suppose she must have looked rather delighted, for Mrs. Darling put her hand to her heart and said, "Oh, why can't you remain like this forever?" This was all that passed between them on the subject, but henceforth, Wendy knew that she must grow up. You always know after year two. Two is the beginning of the end. Of course, they lived at 14, and until Wendy came, her mother was the chief one. She was a lovely lady with a romantic mind and such a sweet, mocking mouth. Her romantic mind was little tiny boxes, one within the other, that came out with a puzzling ease. However many you discovered, there's always one more. And her sweet, mocking mouth had one kiss on it that Wendy could never quite get, though it was there perfectly conspicuous in the right-hand corner. The way Mr. Darling wondered was this. The many gentlemen who had been boys when she was a girl discovered simultaneously that they loved her. And they all ran to her house to propose to her except Mr. Darling, who took a cab and nipped in first. And so he got her. He got all of her except the innermost box and the kiss. He never knew about the box, and in time he gave up trying for the kiss. Wendy thought Napoleon could get it, but I can picture him trying and then going off in a passion and slamming the door. Mr. Darling used to boast to Wendy that her mother not only loved him, but respected him. He was one of those deep ones who knew about stocks and shares. But of course, no one really knows, but he quite seemed to know, and he often said stocks were up and the shares were down in a way that would have made any woman respect him. Wendy came first, then John, then Michael, and after a week or two after Wendy came, it was doubtful whether they would be able to keep her, as she was another mouth to feed. Mr. Darling was frightfully proud of her, but he was honorable and sat on the edge of Mrs. Darling's bed, holding her hand and calculating expenses, while she looked at him imploringly. "Well, I don't interrupt," he said. "I have £1.17 here. That's British money. And I think that we can keep her." In a story that begins like that, you want to read the rest. This is Peter Pan by J.M. Barrie. And as I always say, it's always fun to read the original and then see what happens. Thank you for joining me, and I'll see you next time.